Pulling a controller, and now they do. Every game will have pre-thumbsticks they can use to control any application that they want. In real time, calculated from the 6 people at a time, all rank of the next generation connect to the Xbox One. That's a brief overview of the tech and the software capabilities. I would love to get 3 additional volunteers up here, and then we can have some fun. Yeah, 3 more people. Come on up, don't be shy. Don't bother raising your hands. Come on up. Anybody want to help us push it? Yeah, come on up. This isn't grade school, you don't have to raise your hand. Alright, just go ahead and line up next to Dan here. You can't see people yet, we're still working on that. Alright, we got 6 people. Can you bring up Skeletal for me, Michelle, by pushing the D-pad to the left twice. Alright, let's get the wave going. Kick us off, Dan. Alright, now send it back. Very good. Alright, how about the Harlem Shake? Anyone want to do that? Alright, let's move over to Blockman now. Let's see your best robot impression. Alright, now power down. Thank you to our volunteers. We're gonna open up the stage. Anybody who wants to come on out and check it out, you're more than welcome to. Take a picture of yourself in the death map, post it to Facebook.
Games I can only dream of making before are totally possible.
With Project Spark, kick this off.
Project Spark has the power, joy, and freedom of creating worlds at my fingertips. I control how everyone behaves with the tap of my finger. Playing is creating. Create whenever and wherever an idea strikes. The most amazing part of Project Spark is the power to share games with the touch of a ton amongst a vast and diverse community of gamers. I want to change the game. I want to see what it makes. I want Project Spark.
my colleague Michelle here, and we work on Kinect together. She's got her two volunteers, and we're going to show you the next generation of Kinect, what it's capable of, and some of the fun that we're having with it. To kick things off, what you're looking at is the actual three-dimensional depth view of our next generation Kinect sensor. This is not a 2D grayscale image. As they stick their arms out, as they stick their hands out, you can see they're actually calculating where they are in 3D space in real time. If I can get you all to move closer to the sensor, we'll talk about some of the detail that we have. So take a look at the wrinkles of their clothes. You can see their tongues pretty clearly, the curls in their hair. They're having a good time with it. We have 3 times the fidelity with this sensor than we did over the Xbox 360. It's a really unprecedented level of technology. The other thing I'll point out is how close they can get to the sensor. So no matter the size of your living room, you're going to be able to participate. Look how incredibly close they are. Might get you to come all the way back to the back of the carpet. So we did up close, and you can see exactly how far they can get. Some people like to just stick just their head in. You look like you're hanging on the wall. That's a 100-yard. So look at how wide the field of view is. Look at how big it is. You know, a phenomenal improvement over where we were before. So this is great for our computer algorithms, but you know, for looking at it, I prefer the color feed. So this is our 1080p HD color feed on the next generation Kinect. It's fantastic for Skype to Skype in your living room if you want everybody to show up, or if you have a high resolution picture of the gamer and you want to bring them into the game, put their likeness on a multiplayer character and have some fun with it. Really nothing that you can do better. The only downside to the color feed, and everybody who's taken a picture with a mobile phone knows, is that it's very lighting dependent. I can turn the lights down, I would, but they just don't let them for some reason. But we did give our next generation Kinect the ability to see in the dark. So what you're looking at right now is our active IR feed, true lighting independence. Not only can it see in the dark, but we can subtract out all other light sources as well. So I've got Michelle with her handy dandy flashlight there. You can see as she's using the flashlight on the color feed on her volunteers, it's showing up. But in the active IR image, it's completely subtracted away. You can't see the TV, you can't see the flashlight, you can't see the overhead lights, you can't see anything. So this is a phenomenal platform by which we build all of our computer vision technology. Works great, I play games in the dark, I watch TV in the dark, it's fantastic. So that's kind of the eyes of the sensor. Now I'm going to talk to you about the brains. We take those hardware feeds, our engineering know-how, and use things like our real-time HD skull tracking. So, we can track up to 6 players simultaneously, 25 joints per player. Look at the realism, look at the accuracy. We got a couple of live ones up here. They're having a good time with it. Tracking them in real time. Also check out the detail on the hands. We've got joints for the tip of hands and the tip of thumbs. So phenomenal real-time skeletal tracking. We know how the bones are connected. We also know their orientation. So this is Block Man. We got a good robot, now's the time to bust it out. Yeah, really good. So now we can tell the difference between a regular old tennis swing and one that has topspin or backspin. It's really a phenomenal step forward. You want to, you know, send your bowling ball down the road and then put a little spin on it, we can take care of all that. So how the bones are together is pretty interesting, but we also have to describe muscle and force. So I like to call this little demo Muscle Man. It's a real-time human-based physics simulation. So the intensity of the color represents feeling in their muscles and in their joints and in their bones. So if you kind of like shift your weight between each feet.